guys, so back again, do the price video, my everyday Blinkers mug, drinking some nice coffee. Check them out, by the way. So just wanted to go over a little bit of like how much the KLR build is going to cost overall. And I'll just go ahead and start by saying this bike is totally not worth what I'm about to pay to rebuild it. So don't see me do it and think it's like a good idea just because it is a lot of money and it's four to five times as much as the bike is worth. I bought this bike about 3 years ago, two or 3 years ago. Can't remember how exactly when. Have to look on the title. I bought it for $1,200. And let's just say it's going to be a lot more than that to completely rebuild it and fix it like I want to. Part of the reason I'm willing to do this is just because of the story that goes behind the bike, or at least behind me getting the bike, I should say. I'll save that story for another video. I'm just gonna make this one kind of short. So basically what I'm gonna do to the bike is strip it all the way down to the frame, sandblast it, paint the frame. I'm gonna black out the frame, black out the engine. I gotta get all new plastics, and just the plastic kit alone is $500. That's the front fender, rear fender, tank shrouds, and the little side pieces that go on it. So that's $500 right there. Okay, another $550 is if I decide to go with the upgraded piston and cylinder kit. So currently it's like a 651, I think, cc. I'm looking at and probably going to end up going with a 692 kit. So I'll buy a bored out cylinder and an oversized piston, give me a little more horsepower, a little bit less oil burning, because these bikes are famous for burning oil. And then I've got a bunch of like little stuff, like a low profile magnetic drain plug. Not that I really honestly need it to be magnetic, but whatever. Full body and engine crash bars, that's gonna cost me about $250. Gotta get the carb rebuilt because I let it sit too long without being run, so the carb's gummed up. Brakes aren't that great, so I got front brake caliper, rear brake caliper rebuild kits, front and rear master cylinder rebuild kits, new brake lines, new sprockets, chain, skid plate, an aluminum skid plate. It has a plastic skid plate on it now, and that's just not going to do anything in terms of protection. So I'm going to get a aluminum skid plate. That's $115. So the rear brake rotor is $60. Just like, it's a little, but it's not that bad. The front brake rotor, on the other hand, is $150. It's just kind of ridiculous to me. Let's see what else we got here. Some of the big items we got. Oh, main wiring harness. The wiring harness that is on it now, as you saw in the last video, it's screwed. It's been messed with so many times. So I'm just gonna get a new wiring harness, and that we're looking at $214 for the rear, excuse me, for the main. Another $40 for the rear harness, and I think the dash wiring harness is $100. I'm also looking at getting a lock set, which I have to get a new gas cap, which is $25. And then the lock set will give me the ignition, a little key tumbler to go in the gas cap, and the helmet thing on the back, which I won't even put that on. But that'll at least give me to where I can have the key for the ignition, also run the gas cap backwards. That's $175. just for that. Fork rebuild kit, because I do have to rebuild the forks. They're pretty shot. $130. Fork springs, $103. $104, really. $50 for some new handguards. $100 for the front and rear spoke kits. And I'm hoping, really hoping, that I can fix the rear rim with the new spoke set. Because I kind of screwed it up a little bit when I changed the tires. So I'm really hoping that I can pull that together with the spoke kit instead of having to buy a whole new rim, because that is several hundred dollars for a new rim. So I'm really hoping not to do that. And then I've also got, you know, a couple of like tools that I would need. You know, I got a spoke wrench, a spoke torque wrench, a new balancing stand, because mine is kind of trash. One of those Harbor Freight specials. Flywheel puller, which is only like $5. I got sprocket wrench kit, repair manuals, freaking $30. Alignment tools, stuff like that. And I'm also looking at putting in new headlight. I'm going with a LED headlight, $120. Let's see, I've got, as far as parts right now, I have 68 lines of parts that I want to get. That is probably gonna change. I'll probably add more. So what the cost I have right now, I'm quite sure is going to be a lot higher. And I also have 13 lines of tools. Again, that'll probably go up too. Total parts cost right now, without me adding anything more at this very moment, is $4,402.65. Total tool cost I'm looking at, $366.51. So right now, if nothing changed, which I guarantee it will, my total cost for the completed build is $4,769.16. I'm really thinking by the time it's all over with, I'll be around $5,500 most likely, especially if I have to buy a new rim. Like I said, I paid $1,200 for this bike a few years ago, and it's just gonna cost me way much more than this bike is worth, and I know it's not worth it. I'll never get this money back if I ever decide to sell it, and that's not why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because I like the bike, and there's a story behind it for me. Like I said, I'll hit that in a later video. So you guys are gonna see this video. I'm also making a YouTube channel, so I'll upload to IGTV and YouTube. So you can watch it on whichever one, and I don't think YouTube will compress the video as much, because even though it was shot in 2.7K on Instagram, it doesn't really look like it was, so can't help compression. So, or maybe I can, I just don't know how. Anyway, next video you guys will see, I'm gonna sandblast, fix the dent, and prime the gas tank. I'm not gonna paint it yet because I don't know exactly what color I'm gonna go with yet. So I'll go ahead and get it sandblasted, primed, and that'll be the next video. And like I said before, this is not gonna be a consistent upload because it's just so much money and it's gonna take me quite a bit of time to get everything together. Hope you guys will stick around and watch it till the end. And then once I get to the end, hopefully I'll do like this big reveal video and photo shoot and all that stuff. That'll be super cool. So thanks for tuning in and catch you in the next one.